The scripture that I want to talk to you about is John 14:1-4. And this is Jesus talking. He's sitting with, just to give you an idea, he's sitting with the disciples, it's the Last Supper. And he's sitting there and he knows that the time is near for him to go. And he has a thorough understanding of everything that's taking place. And the scripture reads, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me," says Jesus. "In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that..." Excuse me. "If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you there myself, that where I am, you will be also. And you know the way to where I am going." But he's referring to heaven. And if we can imagine the house of God, what the house of God looks like, if in his blessing, the house of God, the kingdom of heaven is huge. It's a great mystery that we won't know until we get there. But if the Word of God is inspired, written by man, but inspired by God, this is true. But now we need to understand, or we should reflect on, that Jesus came. Jesus came and took me up. This is what it says. I will come again and take you myself, that where I am, you will be also. I have something to read. It was a poem that was selected by the family. It's titled The Poem of Life. Life is but a stopping place, a pause in what's to be, a resting place along the road to sweet eternity. We all have different journeys, different paths along the way. We were all meant to learn some things, but never meant to stay. Our destination is a place far greater than we know. For some, the journey's quicker. For some, the journey's slow. And when the journey finally ends, we'll claim a great reward and find an everlasting peace together with the Lord. There are a few songs that the family chose. So while the songs are playing, I'd like for you to reflect on the times that you were able to spend with me, all of the great memories that you had together.
I can't feel it till my stubborn heart. I let things that don't matter get in my against me.
Miguel Angel Garcia passed away on Saturday, September the 7th, 2013 in Austin, Texas. He is survived by his children, Genevieve Jean, Portia Nadine, and Rome Stephen. His father, Jose, and three brothers, Juan, Jorge, and Fernando Garcia. He is preceded in death by his beloved mother, Teresa Garcia, who passed away in 1999. Miguel lived in El Paso, Texas, and had recently relocated to Austin, Texas. He loved the outdoors, camping, hiking, and was a mountain bike enthusiast. Miguel attended Sam Houston High School and was furthering his education at the local community college. Miguel, you'll be in our hearts forever. May you rest in peace in paradise. Now, as we continue, we're going to take the next couple of minutes to pay our final respects to Miguel. From there, we will proceed to our vehicles. The immediate family will stay to have their private time with Miguel, and then we'll continue to the grave site. Afterward, the family or everyone is invited to Fratelli's Banquet Hall at 1330 Wirt Road in Houston, Texas. It's on the corner of Wirt and Westview until 3 p.m.
As we prepare to take Mr. Garcia to his final place of rest, we will invite you all a final opportunity to pay your respects on this morning. We ask that everyone, with the exception of the family, report to your cars to allow the family private time to say goodbye to their loved one. Everyone, please stand.